Hi, my name is Brian Keller. I'm a technical evangelist for Microsoft. In this video, I'm going to be telling you about some of the ways in which Visual Studio 2013 and Team Foundation Server 2013 can help you bake application quality right into the software that you're building. I'll be going over everything in a high level, so there will be other demonstrations as other videos in this track that will take you into a closer look at how these capabilities work. But for now, let's just focus on a high-level overview of some of the different areas that you'll find in this product launch. Before we dive into what Visual Studio 2013 offers, let me talk about some of the trends that I see across the software development industry. One of the first things that is probably prominent across almost every size organization that I talk to is that testing needs to be done continuously. Almost every development team I talk to is shipping much more frequently today than they were even 1 to 2 years ago. And what that means is that you have to continuously be testing your software, because if you're continuously shipping software, you don't just get to take 2 or 3 months off at the end of a development cycle to make sure that you're just focusing on fixing bugs. So this needs to be done as part of everything we do. Another trend that I see is that stakeholders and operations play an increasingly important role in quality enablement. You need to make sure that your end users are happy with the software you deliver, and they're oftentimes asked to frequently engage, even as the software is being developed, to make sure that it meets their expectations. And of course, once you ship the software to production, your job's not done as a developer, because operations is going to come back to you and surface important bugs or feedback from end usage trends that you can use to drive future iterations of your development. The other problem that unfortunately is still too common is this idea of no repro, where a tester might find a bug, they'll file that bug over to the developer, and the developer takes a look at that bug and is unfortunately unable to reproduce the environmental conditions that the tester found the bug in. And so we want to try to give you some great technology to help so that when the tester does find a bug, it makes it very easy for the developer to take a look at what was happening on the tester's machine to try to understand what the root cause may have been. We've also seen a trend in exploratory testing. It's also called agile testing. Exploratory or agile testing means that you're basically allowing your testers to go off the beaten path, if you will, and try to do things that they think might break the software and result in unexpected behavior, eventually filing bugs. The challenge with this is that doing exploratory testing well is a really tricky challenge. Oftentimes it results in bugs that are hard to reproduce. It's hard to make sure that if you do find a bug and a developer fixes it, how do you make sure that you continue testing that software in the future the same way so that you don't regress it? So in another video in this session, I'll be showing you ways in which Microsoft Test Manager can help you actually embrace exploratory testing and overcome these objections. And of course, cross-platform and cross-browser testing is important as well. And so our approach with Visual Studio 2013 and Team Foundation Server 2013 is to make sure that we're introducing quality at every step along the lifecycle. And I'll take you just through a few of the scenarios in which we make quality possible. For software testers, Visual Studio 2013 delivers several capabilities, one of which is manual testing. This is our Microsoft Test Manager solution that we've offered since 2010. It's a place for you to capture your test plan, for you to author and organize test cases, for you to run these test cases and capture rich diagnostics as you run through those test cases, which can then be filed back to the developer, complete with files such as IntelliTrace files or video recordings or event logs that show exactly what was happening when the tester was running through that test case. And this can be done for both formal testing and exploratory testing. Another thing that we introduced recently is web-based test case management. So Microsoft Test Manager is a great solution when you're testing on a Windows operating system, but when you need to test on a third-party operating system such as Mac or Linux, then web-based test case management allows you to run those tests on those operating systems and capture bugs as you go. For software developers who might be writing automated tests, Visual Studio offers a lot of capabilities as well, the first of which, of course, is unit testing. In 2012, we overhauled our support for unit testing by introducing third-party adapter support so that you can run tests using the traditional Visual Studio unit testing frameworks, or you can also use third-party adapters like InUnit and XUnit. As part of that overhaul, we also went back and wanted to reevaluate all the different ways that testers interact with tests within Visual Studio. And so we've done a lot of work to make it easy to run large lists of tests and be able to organize your tests as you go, and just make it a lot easier to work with large lists of tests. My colleague Joshua Weber has a video that he'll take you through elsewhere in this track and show you some of the improvements we've made there. We also have continued to make investments in our functional testing, our coded UI testing, if you will. This is for writing tests that simulate what a user might do when they are clicking a mouse or typing, interacting with a keyboard. And so what we've done is we've delivered that for Windows applications, including Windows Store applications. And we also have an ability for you to write those in Internet Explorer and then play those back in third-party browsers such as Firefox and Chrome. And so that's a really great way for you to simulate user activity and surface bugs that a user might see, but by making those entirely automated test runs, which is great. Web performance testing allows you to record a series of HTTP or HTTPS interactions and play those back against maybe a web server, and then make sure that you're getting the expected results, not only functionally, but also in the time that you expect. So this is a really great way to drill into kind of the service level of your applications and make sure that they're performing correctly. And then, of course, load testing is a way that you can string multiple tests together and see what happens when you're web application is needing to serve up, you know, hundreds or thousands or even tens of thousands of users. The other thing that we've done with this release is we've made it possible for you to run those load tests using the power of the cloud. And so traditionally, you would have needed to maintain your own test rig, which would simulate those virtual users. And you have to set up those machines and maintain those machines on a regular basis anytime you want to run load tests. Well, because load testing is one of those activities that's usually only done a few times each iteration, we thought that was a perfect opportunity to take advantage of the elastic scale of the cloud. So with Visual Studio Online, combined with Visual Studio 2013, you can now do that. And then finally, we continue to make available our lab management solution, which allows you to automatically provision a set of virtual machines and to kick off build, deploy, test workflows against those machines. You can also set up build, deploy, test workflows against physical environments. And in 2012, we introduced the ability for you to use what we call standard environments, which can be physical machines or they can be running third-party virtualization stacks. Really, any machines that can run Windows can now participate as part of a build, deploy, test workflow. But of course, testing is not just for developers and testers. We also want to make sure that end users have an opportunity to participate in the software quality process. One of the tools that we make available as part of the tool set is called the Microsoft Feedback Client. With a Microsoft Feedback Client, I can send a request over to an end user and ask them to run through maybe a user acceptance test or just really look at any part of my web application or a rich client application and give feedback. Now, since oftentimes teams are distributed and you can't be in every place at every time as a product owner or as a developer, what the feedback client does is it automatically captures rich information about how the user is using your software. So here in the screenshot, you can see that I can capture a screen recording with voice annotations. I can capture screenshots or leave notes or maybe take a screen capture and then annotate that to show exactly where I want a new column added as an example. So that's how we're baking stakeholder feedback directly into everything you do on the software development team. And then, of course, I mentioned operations earlier. So we've worked in tight collaboration with our partners on the System Center team. And what we've done is we've actually delivered a set of capabilities that allows you to do a few things related to quality. One is called testing in production, where you can actually monitor your extranet web application from a variety of data centers from around the world that Microsoft runs. And this is just going to give you an indication about whether or not a particular web application that you might be servicing up is having challenges being reached from a particular geography. So here on the map in this screenshot, you can see a couple of places where we're not actually meeting our service level agreement for those particular geographies. Another thing that we've done is we've integrated System Center Operations Manager with Team Foundation Server. So what that means is that as an IT professional who might be finding an issue over an Operations Manager, I have the ability to assign that to the engineering team. That will create a new incident in Team Foundation Server, and then that incident contains everything that Operations Manager already knows about the application and the exception that it had, or maybe a performance violation threshold that was exceeded, so that when the developer gets this incident assigned to them, they'll have hopefully everything they need to understand what's going on and to quickly fix the problem. So those were just a few of the ways I get excited about how Visual Studio 2013 and Team Foundation Server 2013 can help you bake software quality into the applications that you deliver. Be sure to check out the rest of the videos in this track to see demonstrations of how these capabilities work.